am Dr. B. Adimurthy, Assistant Professor in Electrical Engineering, Government College of Engineering, Bargur. Today, I am going to talk few words about the stability in control system and the role of compensator in control system. Few words regarding the role of a compensator in a control system. So, in control system, the stability is very important. Stability means when all the system parameters are within the specified limit, the system is said to be stable. Mathematically, when the poles and zeros are in the left half of the S plane, the system is said to be a stable system. For a system to be stable, increasing the gain of the system will not meet over our requirement. Hence, therefore, a compensator is needed. So, a compensator, there are three types of compensator: lag compensator, lead compensator, and lag lead compensator. Lag compensator is nothing but a low pass filter. Lead compensator is nothing but a high pass filter. So, a compensator is needed to obtain a desired performance of the system. This can be done by adjusting the forward path gain or inserting a compensating device in a control system. So, the steady state error ESS can be reduced by increasing the forward path gain, but this results in making the system more oscillatory, or even the system becomes unstable. Under this situation, the compensating network can be introduced in the system. The compensator network, when it is introduced, when the compensator is introduced, the addition of poles and zeros in the original system. It means addition of poles and zeros in the original system. So feedback compensation scheme is the one of the important in compensating scheme. So feedback compensation scheme means a compensating network, it is introduced in the feedback network. So a feedback network may be connected seriously or also parallelly. So coming to a phase lead compensation, in phase lead compensation, the capacitance is connected parallel with the resistance. So the transfer function, the final transfer function obtained from the phase lead compensation is alpha into ST plus 1 divided by 1 plus alpha ST, where alpha is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2, and T is equal to R1C, where T is the time constant, alpha is the attenuation component. So the transfer function can also be expressed in the sinusoidal form also by letting S is equal to J omega. So from the phase lead compensation, the pole zero configuration or Bode plot for the phase lead network can also be obtained. So the pole zero configuration says that the zero is nearer to the origin. So the effect of zero is dominant. Therefore, the phase lead network allows to have a increased phase shift. This allows to pass high frequency and low frequencies are attenuated. As the gain is reduced at low frequencies, additional gain is needed in the system to account for the reduction in gain. So next, coming to phase lag compensation, the transfer function of phase lag compensation is ST plus 1 divided by beta into ST plus 1 is the transfer function of phase lag compensation, where T equal to R2C, beta is equal to R1 plus R2 divided by R2, where beta is the attenuation factor, t is the time constant. So the transfer function can also be represented in the sinusoidal form by letting s is equal to j omega. Here the pole zero configuration, the pole is nearer to the origin compared to zero, so the effect of pole is dominant. This makes the phase shift in a reduced manner when used in cascade with the original system. This lag network allows to pass low frequency and attenuate the high frequency. So comparing to phase lead network and phase lag network, the phase lead network shifts the gain crossover frequency point to a higher value, so the bandwidth is increased, thus improving the speed of the response and overshoot is being reduced. Whereas in phase lag network, it shifts the gain crossover frequency to low value, thus decreasing the bandwidth and steady state error is improved. Here, whereas in phase lead network, the steady state error is not improved more. Whereas in phase lag network, the speed of the response is reduced. Next, while coming to the phase lag lead compensation, the combination of lag network and lead network is called as phase lag lead compensation. With the phase lead compensation network, the gain margin and phase margin can be adjusted to a desired value. The increase in bandwidth results in reduction of settling time and thus the speed of the time response is improved. When phase margin is needed more than 60 degrees, excessive increase in gain is required. In this case, two lead network are used in series. To have a stabilized system, lead compensation is used. The steady state accuracy is improved using lag network. Lag lead compensation, lead lag compensation or lag lead compensation is employed where the fast time response as well as better steady state accuracy is desired. So the compensators can also be designed using Bode plot technique in frequency response analysis and in time response analysis. The root locus technique also used to design the compensator. So now coming to the procedure for a design of a lag compensator using root locus technique, the following procedures or steps are followed to design the compensator. First thing is, procedure for designing a lag compensator using root locus technique. First step is to draw the root locus of a uncompensated system. Next step is determine the dominant pole SD. Draw a straight line through the origin with an angle of cos inverse of delta with respect to the negative real axis. The intersection point of the line with the root locus gives the dominant pole SD. Next, determine the open loop gain of the uncompensated system. S is equal to SD. Let the gain be K. The open loop gain K at S is equal to SD on the root locus is given by product of vector length from SD is equal to open loop poles and divided by determination of open loop gain for the uncompensated system should be obtained by the product of vector length from SD to the open loop poles divided by the product of vector length from SD to open loop zeros. So after that, we have to calculate the parameters of beta of the compensator, where beta is the attenuation factor. Let K be U, that is the velocity error constant of the uncompensated system, and the K be D, that is the desired velocity error constant, where KVU is equal to limit s tends to 0 s into g of s. Let A is a factor by which the velocity error of the system has to be increased, where A is equal to KVD divided by KVU, where KVD is the desired velocity error constant and KVU is the uncompensated system, that is the velocity error constant of the uncompensated system. So next step is choose the beta 10% to 20% greater than A. So next thing is determine the transfer function of the lag compensator. The zeros of the lag compensator 1 by T is chosen to be 10% of the second pole of uncompensated system. So zero, zeros of the compensator is given by minus 1 by T and time constant which is also given by 1 by minus pole of the lag compensator PC is equal to minus 1 by beta T. So the transfer function of lag compensator is given by GC of S plus 1 by T divided by S plus 1 by beta T, where beta into S 1 by 1 plus ST divided by 1 plus S into beta T. So after that we should determine the open loop transfer function of the compensated system. So the network with the compensator is added to the overall transfer function of the system. Hence the open loop transfer function of the compensated system is given by G of S is equal to GCS into G of S, that is GC is the compensated transfer function of the system. So after that we have to check whether the compensated system satisfies the steady state error requirements. If not, repeat the design by modifying the location of poles and zeros of the compensator. Similarly, the design procedure can also be obtained for lead compensator, lag lead compensator. So we shall see the design procedure for lag compensator, lead compensator in Bode plot, using Bode plot in the next session. Thank you.